Hey guys, how you doing today? It's your girl, Miss Debs. I'm coming to you from here in my kitchen in Orange, New Jersey, giving honor to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, because he's so worthy to be acknowledged and praised on this day and any other day. Wouldn't you guys agree? Because without God, there could be no me, no you, no us, no this. Guys, today I'm doing some cleaning, some organizing, and some decluttering, trying to make up some space and get rid of the old, not to bring in no more new. Okay, so come with me, guys. I'm going to show you a couple of things. Now, guys, I took away all the Christmas stuff, finally. The little cocoa station that I had for the girls. So I brought back some of my pots and stuff, my Instapot and things that I need to be cooking with because it's wintertime. So I put that back in its space. And I'm going to show you the drawers. Remember, I did the decluttering on the drawers, so they stayed pretty good. Got everything packed up just like I needed, right? Tools and cooking instruments under all the plastic and different little stuff in there. Okay, so I stay true to that. Let's look at this drawer. You were with me when I decluttered this drawer. It's still in good shape. I'm thankful for that, right? So now I did this down here a while ago. So now I have like my pots and pans, my baking bowls up on the top. I told you guys I utilize every piece of space I have. I have my pot tops and this these popcorn container with different little plastic utensils. Pots and pans back there. Bags, tablecloths, and there's even stuff back there that I use, right? Okay, so that's pretty decent and clean. But this is the elephant in the room. Let's address this elephant in this room. And right here, good Lord, I'm going to show you guys. This is what I've been meaning to do for my, it goes all the way back there. And I'm going to take these things out. This is just some scratch up on the bottom where the pots and pans are at that bottom there. But anyway, I'm going to take all these pots and pans out. You're going to see me do it. And I'm going to throw things out. And then I'm going to try to set things up in there nice and neat. Getting rid of a lot of things that I'm not using. Get rid of it. And the next one I'm going to tackle is this drawer. All the other drawers are good. So that's my big elephant in the room. And then next I'll do this. I don't know if I'm going to do that today. And I'm good as far as the kitchen getting declutterized. So come with me, guys. Let's get this started. Okay, guys, so I have it cleaned out down there. Then I'm going to take the things that's under there out. But that was pretty neat under there. But I still want to take it out and sweep because little remnants was down here from creatures, if you know what I mean. So now I have some bleachy water, deodorizing bathroom cleaner, and some Lysol wipes. So I'm going to get down there and I'm going to start scrubbing this out. Okay, so this is the after the clean. So I did the bottom shelf and the top shelf. Then I have all the dishes laid out that I'm getting ready to wash. I have a lot of party items that I use, like the decorative plates when you're doing your chips and dips. And I have all the holiday items, the trays that hold the holiday items for like Thanksgiving and Christmas. Have some pans over here. Lots of things on the floor that I'm keeping. Got out some garbage bags because I have some things to throw away. Over there I have my mini grill and a couple of things over in the deep freezers that I'm going to keep. And then here's all junk. Just things that I'm not using anymore. It's not in a condition to give to someone because I would give it away instead of throwing it away. But I don't want people to have things that I'm no longer using. And if I don't feel like it's good enough for me to use, I don't want to pass it on to someone else, giving them my junk that's unusable, you know? So, I have my dishes in the sink. So now I'm showing you guys that I'm throwing away all of this trash. And I got 4 bags of trash out of that, believe it or not. One of them was the garbage. But a lot of things were thrown in the garbage from me cleaning up under the cabinets. So I have cabinets all over the kitchen, as you can see. But when you have so much junk and you're not decluttering and you're not like rotating things that you're no longer using, now I'm washing the dishes. Okay, so this is the reveal. I'm showing you that one last time. Some pots and pans down there, baking bowls, lists, other things, utensils, popcorn holder, containers, tablecloth, and bags. So in this was the elephant in the room. Okay, so under here we have, it's kind of dark, let me try to put it. You can see it. This was the elephant in the room. So here we have the party entertainer platters and holiday platters. Under there we had the tortilla bowls, the baking pans. We have our pie dishes and cake plates there. Here we have devil egg dishes and trays. We have little gadgets to hold up when we put stuff in the stove, like if we roasted the chicken. We got the pots there, more pots. Here we have some more pots down back there, and then we have the frying pans. So we are done with that, guys. So we are recamping everything. This is the drawer that I did, I think, back in the spring or whatever, but now that's still together, right? I straighten it out every now and again, just, you know. This is clean, believe it or not. This is the other drawer with all the utensils and stuff in it. I showed you down here with the bags, the tablecloth, pots and pans, utensils. And, okay, so you've seen all that. I threw mothballs in all of the cabinets. Down here, this is it. Let me turn that flashlight on. I thought I had the flashlight on. Bear with me, guys. Okay, so it's clean down there. Put the light on for you so you can see all the party utensils, the pans, the frying pans, the cake pans, the bundt pans, the pie pans. Now we're doing the drawer down here. I'm showing you all the sponges, the daddy scrubber, all the other sponges, and I found some sponges at the other drawer, so I'm just putting that down there. And all my dish rags are down there as well, so that's where I keep all the dish rags, the sponges, and things like that of that sort. And then over here, oh, I have a sponge right, that's a Christmas sponge that I ordered from Timor and I never used. That's my still wool pad. And then I have over there my empanada makers, the hamburger makers. Then I have all my utensils up here, different little items that I use when I'm making donuts to put the holes in them, cookie ice cream scoopers and cookie scoopers. And then I also have in there my can openers. So now this is the one that I said I wasn't going to do, but I did wind up doing it. I have all my measurement cups down there. I have all the bowls that was in the back, all my holiday platters and stuff down there as well, because they're different than the other ones. So there's a method to my madness. I have a grater over there, the red one in the corner. Then I have my air fryer black holders that goes in the liners that goes inside the air fryer. Then I have all my different utensils right there. There's two measuring cups, and then the other things where you, what do you call them things, the orange things right there that you use to put stuff into a jar or bowl and you don't want to spill it. I swear I got a brain fart. Anyway, you'll figure it out for me. Also, I have other type of Betty Crocker dishes down there in containers. And then I have my colanders in the back and some bowls that I use, like big bowls. Then I have all my cleaners down near. Brillo dish cleaner. Then I have some Myers cleaner down near, all-purpose cleaner. Have my garbage bags in the little basket, some magic erases, some dish detergent extra down there, and some stove cleaner. And because I don't like going in that closet all the time that I'm showing you now, so I try to bring things closer to me, because I will have to move the little, you know, the chair and the bench to get over there by the little refrigerator to extract things out of the food pantry. That's why I keep all my items stored, and I get tired of doing that, so I try to put things down near. And I have some laundry detergent back there as well. So that's things that I keep on that side, cleaning utensils and things that I need that will be closer to me, that I don't have to keep moving the chair when I want to get things out of the food pantry that I store a lot of my items. So I did wind up cleaning down there. It looks great, I must add. I'm so thankful that God gave me the strength to do it with the pain that I was in. But decluttering, it makes you feel good once you do it, doesn't it, guys? I hope this is some motivation to you, because the first thing to do when you start to clutter, to declutter and organize and clean, is to put in your mind it's going to be done. I feel good. I brought some of my fall items back out to help me with my cooking. I'll be taking it down again because I let Christmas stuff stay up for so long. It kind of took me back a little bit, but that's okay. We got it together. I'm showing you how nice and clean everything is, because you know your girl is an OCD chick. She can't help herself, and it was killing me that I couldn't get under there to get. So I said, you're going to get your butt on this floor today. You're going to sit down, take out all the pots and pans and all the things that you need to get rid of. You're going to clean, declutterize, reorganize. And I'm not buying any more new items. I have enough baking and cooking items and pans and pots and bowls and measurement things. We don't need it. So you just have to, what I was just beginning to say, first thing is to realize you have to declutter. With the decluttering comes, you have to clean out what you had everything down there cluttered in. And then you have to see, number three, what am I keeping? What am I throwing out? And that's what you have to do. One, to declutterize. Two, to clean it out. And three, to see what am I keeping. If you, even if you have to make little piles or get bags or get things to hold, like little crates and stuff or whatever you use, make one for keeping, one for throwing away, and one for giving away. But in my case, I didn't feel like I needed to give that to anybody, because if I didn't want to use it anymore in the condition some of it was in, I didn't want to put that on anybody else, you know? So that's why I did have four bags to throw out. And again, I'm asking you here, what do you call those things? The orange things and the blue one right there. When you transferring something from one container to another, I swear, C has messed me up, and y'all know what I'm talking about. I don't want to get striked for it, but ever since I had that, my brain is shocked. Little things that I normally could remember. I'm relatively a decent, smart person, but some things just don't come to mind when I'm talking. Ever since I had that, can you relate? Help a girl out.